करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरति य उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐमित्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् पेज् 358 तै मे सत्याः कामाः अनुतापिधानाः तेषां सत्यानां सताम् अनुदम् अभिधानं यो यो हि अस्य इतः प्रैति नदम् इह दर्शनाय लभते अथे च अस्य इह जीवाः ये च प्रेताः यच्चन्यत् इच्छन् न लभते सर्वं तत् अत्र गत्वा विन्दते अत्र हि अस्येते सत्याः कामाः अनृतापिधानाः तद्यथापि हिरण्यधिं निहितम् अक्षेत्रज्ञाः उपर्युपरि सञ्चरन्तः न विन्देयुः एवमेव इमाः सर्वाः प्रजाः अहरः गच्छन्त्यः एतं ब्रह्मलोकं न विन्दन्ति अनुतेन हि प्रत्यूढाः ते मे सत्याः कामः अनुत अपिधान अनुतापिधानाः कष्टमिदं खलु वर्तते श्रुति सेज़ इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ ग्रेट सॉरो रिग्रेट यस स्वात्मस्थाः शक्य प्राप्याः अपि इमे सत्याः कामाः दिस अनफेलिंग डिजायर्स ऑन द डिजायरेबल ऑब्जेक्ट्स स्वात्मस्थाः इवन दो दे आर विद इन वन सोन सेल्फ शक्य प्राप्याः प्राप्तुं शक्याः प्राप्ति योग्याः इवन दो they are within the reach of a person because they are located in one's own self. Anto apidanaha. Unfortunately, apidanaha, they are covered by antam, by falsehood. What is the falsehood? Bhashivisheshu stin bhojana chadani chatsudana dishu trishna. Atmasthana, even though they are in one's own self. Swashayana, even though they are located in oneself. They are already accomplished and still. Bhashivisheshu trishna, the craving for external objects is stri, anna, bhojana, achyadana, etc. Svicca, pracharattvam, chitan, nimittam. And the trishna, the craving for the external pleasures, which gives rise to ultimately a loss of self-control. And therefore, unrestrained behavior, because those trishna, the cravings become so strong that there is no control over them. So that is called, so that trishna, the craving, and the unrestrained behavior together is called anutam, is called the falsehood. Basically, ignorance is falsehood. And the false notions about oneself, born of ignorance, is falsehood. Which again brings about the notion that the kama, the pleasures that I desire are outside myself. And that again brings about a desire, a craving for them, and an effort to gain them, leading to unrestrained behavior. So ultimately ignorance and mithya jnana. So mithya agnyananche. So mithya chada agnyananche mithya jnanam. Ignorance, which is itself mithya, or the notions born of ignorance. So thus there is a whole series of what we call anuttam, or the falsehood. Basic anuttam is ignorance about one's own self. Leads to mithya jnanam, the false notions about oneself. That false notion being that I am lacking, wanting, inadequate. That I am needy, that I have to become happy or acquire happiness, and that happiness is lying out there. And stronger the sense of dissatisfaction within, stronger is the craving for the happiness out there. Ultimately, to a point where I become controlled by my desires, the whole thing is called falsehood. And this falsehood covers or veils that very pleasures or happiness which is my own self. Tannimittam satyanam kamanam apraptiti. It is this falsehood that deprives me of the experience of the happiness which is my own self. Because the false notions always keeps me looking outward. Paranchikhani jatrunat svayambhu tasmat parang pashyati. So the mind, the sense organs are external because of this falsehood of the nature of their ignorance and wrong notions. And therefore one is always looking outside for happiness, satisfaction, adequacy. It is that extrovertedness, bahirmukhatvam, which is the grossest or the most evident obstacle to the owning up of one's own self. This is called disowning oneself. Ignorance and false notions, they result into disowning my own self. So apidhanam iva apidhanam. Not that there is a real or a tangible or a substantial curtain or a veil or an obstacle. There is no distance between happiness and myself, no distance in time, no distance in place. Distance is only in terms of ignorance. No real or tangible distance. But that falsehood acts, it creates as though the distance. Just as ignorance creates the distance between the tenth man and the tenth man. And so also this falsehood creates distance between happiness and myself. So apidhanam, eva apidhanam, as though apidhanam, as though a veil. So in what manner do you say that? Katham, anuta apidhananimittam tesham alabha. In what manner does this falsehood or this veil act, that it brings about the non-attainment of the happiness or what I wish? Yo yasmat asyajanto putro bhrata vaishta yasma lokat prayati prayachati. So whoever is departed, it is stated in a very peculiar terms here. In terms of a person desiring something that he doesn't have. So, or desiring something from which he is separated. So, either the association what is undesirable creates happiness, or separation from what is desirable creates unhappiness. So, these are the desirable things. Examples. Putra, bhrata va ishtah, like the son, like the brother, like whatever. But here in the separation is because they have departed. So, itahasman lokat praiti. The putra was here, bhrata was here, and now he is departed from this world. Miyate, he is passed away. And therefore he is samskaras. That he wants them back. He is missing them. And therefore, he has a strong desire for the association with them. Therefore, they are presented here as the examples. So, they are kashe vidyamana vidhi, cannot go away. Looks like they have gone away from him. Or he thinks that they have gone away from me. Depends on what you mean by me. If by me he means only this jivatma confined to this body mind sense complex, and yes, they have gone away, away from him. But if you really realize what the me or I is, that dharakasha, I am dharakasha. What is dharakasha? That which accommodates the whole universe. Within which are located heaven and the earth and the wind and air and the fire and the sun and the moon and the whole universe is located. All the desires are located in which? So that is my dimension, not knowing the dimensions of one's own self. That's called abhimanam. Restricting or cutting down oneself to a limited thing because of identification. Sarvadayakashe vidyamanavapi. It is either you can say that those brothers or the sons, etc., within myself, or the happiness that he used to gain as a result of the association with them is within himself. Even if a person departs from the happiness, does not depart from him. Since he thinks that the happiness is in that person, therefore, a separation from that person to him amounts to separation from happiness. Which cannot be. He cannot be separated from happiness, which is his own nature. Surdayakashe vidyamanavapi. Even though happiness arising from that son or brother, etc., is existing in his own self, in the space of the heart, puna darshanaya icchanna. And when he says he wants to see them, meet with them, he wants happiness basically. When he desires and association with those dear and near ones. What he is desiring is happiness coming from that which is within his own self. Ichchandapi na labhate, but he misses them. That happiness does not come. He cannot feel, even though he thinks about them in his mind, he does not experience the happiness that arises by real association with them. So when you say that they are already within the lotus of his heart, you can say that the happiness is within himself. Or the whole universe is within himself, he really sees his own dimension, that is the dharakas, then he realizes the whole universe is within me. So that's the result of that meditation. See, he's not performed that meditation. See, the great loss. Yachedavedit atasatyamasti nachedihadit mahati vinastihi. What a great loss there is when he does not realize his self when he's here. That great loss is being described here. Athecha seh jivaha yecha pretaha. All these jivas, such as the son or the brother, etc. Yecha pretaha, continuing this earlier passage. So Bhashyakara said, so continuing there were preti, mriyate, putra, bhratava, ishtaha. So asya vidushaya of this person, jiva yecha preta, those who have departed from him. Yecha anything else, icchanna labhate. What an ignorant person does not achieve even though desires. Sarveta tatra gatva vindate. This wise person gets all of them. Why? Because atrayasya de satyaha kamaha antabhidhanaha. Because all those desires are within himself, therefore, going to his own self, he gets them. As far as the ignorant person is concerned, even though they are right here, they do not get with justice. Yathapi hiranyanidhim nihitam akshetrajnaha. So those who do not know the treasure that is buried underneath, upari upari sancharantaha, constantly he walks about, you know, on his field, not knowing what is underneath. Navinavindeyu, they do not attain that treasure, even though he is walking above that. Evameva. So this is a very good example of what ignorance can do. 13th chapter, our Shankaracharya gives other examples from Mahabharata. So see, if you do not know, if you know, then you can avoid all the problems. You're walking. You can see your path, then you can avoid the thorns and pebbles. If you do not know how you are tortured, you know, by thorns and stuff like that. But this is also an example. That if you do not know how you are deprived of the treasure which is yours to claim, be yours to claim, not yours until you claim it to be there. The treasure is yours to claim, but you're deprived of it because you do not know. So the difference between knowledge and ignorance is right here. How ignorance deprives you of what is in fact yours. Eva vaimaha sarvaha prajaha araha gacchantyaha. Similarly, all the ignorant people, every day they go to Brahman. Edam Brahmalokam Navinandi in the deep state, even though everybody goes to Brahmaloka, Navinandi, because they are ignorant, they do not know that I am one with Brahman. Anutaini Pratyudaha, because they are reflected by this falsehood and endeavor, even though they are experiencing Brahman. They do not know that I am experiencing Brahman or I am Brahman. Then they do not know. So going to the Bhashya, as the Tikakara says, Abhidusha Upta Pratibandhat Kama Praptihi Iti Anvaya Muktva. So this is the story about the ignorant person. The anvaya vitarika of an ignorant person. What is anvaya? When the ignorance is there, then there is unattainment of happiness. And ignorance is not there, attainment of happiness. So anvaya means what? Ignorance is accompanied with unattainment. That is anvaya. So when there is ignorance, there is unattainment of what is already there. And when ignorance is not there, there is attainment. So that is vyatirika. So anvaya muktva dhara akasha atmagnyasya vidusha. When ignorance is not there, vidusha for the wise person, dhara akasha atmagnyasya. So wise person means the upasaka who has realized atmagnya, one who is the knower of the self. What is the self? Dhara akasha. So one who has realized dhara akasha brahman as his own self, ukta anuru patibandha abhavat. So vyatirika. Now that ignorance is not there, the consequence of ignorance also are not there. Now that ignorance is not there, the unattainment of happiness also is not there. So pratibandha, anuta pratibandha bhavat, because that falsehood has been removed by the knowledge of the self. So dharakasa atmajnasya vidusha. The vidwan, the wise person, is characterized by atmajnya, the knower of the self. What is the self? Dharakasa, that's the self. So the anutam falsehood has been removed or eliminated or dispelled by the knowledge. Therefore, ukta anuruta pratibandha abhavat. So anuruta or falsehood of the nature was described earlier of ajnanam, mithyajnanam, so trishna, and then svichha, prasaratvam, that sequence of anurutam that was described is no other. So ukta anuruta pratibandha abhavat, because of the now, the absence of the pratibandha, the obstacle, which was created by that anuttam or falsehood. So, apraptihi na iti vyatirekam. So, there is no more the non-attainment of happiness. So, ignorance was there, there was unattainment of happiness. When ignorance is not there, the unattainment also is no more there. So, that vyatireka is said atha punaha iti. So Vashyakara says, atha punaha yeca asya vidushah jantoho jivaha jivanti iha putraha bhratra deova yeca pretaha mṛtāha iṣṭhā sambandhinah yacca anyata iha lōke vastrānna pānādi ratnā divā vastu. Icchanna nalabhate tat sarvam atra udayakashakhe brahmane gatva yathoktena vidina vindate labhate. So atha punaha, on the other hand ye chasya vidushah jantoho. Now vidushah jantoho. This jantu means this person was jantu so far, vidushaya, now he is a vidwan, he is realized, self-realized person. So jivaha yecha pretaha iha jivaha jivanti iha putraha bhratra deva. So now this wise person, those who are dear and alive, bhratra deva putraha, his sons, brothers, etc., those are alive. Yecha preta, bhuta, ishta, sambandhina. And there may be others who are preta, who have departed, ishta, but desirable. Sambandhina is relatives. Means other relatives which he loved, who have departed. So there are those whom he loves, who are alive, such as the son, brother, etc. Or others whom he loved. Like the relatives and friends who have departed. Yach anyata and anything else. Yaloke vastranapanadi ratnadiva. Anything else in this world which is vastranapanadi. The clothes and the food and the drink, etc. Ratnadiva or jewels. So vastu ichchanna labhate. This ignorant person, when he wants them, he doesn't get this. Or he did not get, the ignorant person did not get tat saram. So, atra hrudayakashe brahmani gatva yathoktena vidhana vindate labhate. That now this wise person, so tatra atra gatva. Atra means here, hrudayakasha khe brahmani gatva. Going to, reaching, realizing Brahman, hrudayakasham, which is one's own self. How do you go there? What's meant by going? Yathoktena vidhina. By the vidhi of the meditation that has been described here. Vindate labhate. So, what an ignorant person is deprived of, the wise person gets them. So the tika, yadevaiha icchanapi nalabhate tadeva brahmani gatva labhate. What one does not get here? Here means what? When one is ignorant. Let's go here. And going there means what? In one's own self. So here one does not get. When one has not performed that meditation, when one has not realized the self. And therefore here means one's notion about an individual self, that I'm a jantu, I'm a creature, I'm a jiva, I'm just an individual self, that is called here. And there means what? There means in hrudayakasha, in its true nature. So here means in the self, which is the notion born of ignorance. And there means the same self, which is now known in its true nature. So, what is yadatra tadamutra? What is it? Yadevaiha tadamutra. Yadamutra tadanviha. What is here is there. What is there is here, as Upanishad says. Same. So, what is here and the jiva is there, etc. So, here also it is here and there. Here is in the state of ignorance and there is in the state of knowledge. So Trikakara says, yadevaiha icchinnapi nalabhate. Here, when this person is ignorant, then he does not acquire them or have them even though he desires them. Tadeva, that very same thing which he did not get even though he wanted, brahmani gatva. By going to Brahman, meaning that by realizing Brahman his own self, labhate, he attains him, ityasaha. So Tikagara says, sushupte pranimatrasya brahma gamana sattvevi na yathukta kama prapti drishyadeti. Sushupte pranimatrasya, but everybody goes there. You say that going there you attain. Here you do not attain. When you are identified with the body, mind, sense complex, then you do not attain. When you become free from this identification, and therefore when you experience Brahman, then you do. But that's what happens in deep sleep state. Then every day for everybody in a deep sleep state, there is a freedom from identification with this body, mind, sense complex. And there is sata swami tada sampanna bhavati. He becomes one with soul, with sat or brahman. So sushupte. So then atra gatva. Upanishad says that going here to brahman one attains what one did not get. But then that one, everybody goes to brahman every day. And still they don't seem to get it. So what's the difference? Sushupte pranimatrasya brahma gamana sattvevi. Even though in deep sleep, every prani. So brahma gamana sattvevi. Everybody in fact, including every creature. Not only human beings, every living being in a state of deep sleep becomes one with brahman. Because I am so and so is a notion arising from identification with upadhi. That I call myself a human being and some other creature calls itself a dog or a cat is all in the waking state because of identification with that particular body-mind-sense complex. But in deep sleep state, every creature gives up the identification. Or becomes free from identification by the strength of that, you know, the force of the deep sleep state. Meaning that the influence of the sleep is so much that this fellow becomes, you know, he becomes free from the identification. Therefore, in deep sleep state, a dog and a cat and a monkey and everybody is one, including a king and whatever. And so, everybody gets that. And still, yato upta kama prapti na drushyate. And still one doesn't feel that I have gotten what all I wanted. So that Vashyakara says, yato upta yana vedana gatva. Not only gatva, not only going to Brahman, but going to Brahman in the manner specified by the Upanishad. Everybody goes to Brahman. But here going to Brahman is in a specified way. What is specified way? By meditating, by, you know, and then realizing as one so and so. In that manner you have to go. So you have to go there with knowledge, not going with ignorance. Everybody goes to Brahman every day, but with ignorance. Not that way. When one goes to Brahman with knowledge. So yathoktena vidhina gatva. Because atra gatva, everybody goes to Brahman every day. Then Vashyakara added a qualification, yathoktena vidhina gatva. You go there by realizing that as your own self. Meaning that there is an awareness. When you become merged in Brahman, there is an awareness that I am merged in Brahman. So, it is a difference between the presence and absence of that awareness. So that tikakara says, upasanaya sakshat krutte gatva ityartha. So going to Brahman is specified. Upasanaya sakshat krutte gatva. Realizing Brahman is one's own self by upasana or by meditation. Same thing Anandagiri said, yathoktena vidhanayati. Upasti prakaroktehi. Not only meditation, but the meditation as specified here. Then Anandagiri says, Atmasthanam kamanam anurtapidhanatvam muktam nigamayate. So, what was stated in the previous passage? As to all the kamas, all the desires which are atmasthanam, which are located in one's own self. That, and still there is an attainment of what is already attained because of the distance as though created by the falsehood was stated earlier. Nigamayati, from all these arguments now. So reasons are given, so yukti is given, anubhava also is given to establish that there is something called anutapidhanam. So the experience is stated here. As to how there is a veil of the nature of falsehood. So nigamayati, now that is concluded here, atrayati, bhashyakaras, or the other tikakara says, katham kama prapti ityashankya. Brahmani sarakamanam sattvat tat praptya tat prapti sambhavadeti. Upanishad says that you reach Brahman. How do you attain all the kamas? So reaching Brahman is one thing, but how does that amount to attainment of all the desires or happiness? Idyashangya Brahmani sarvakamaham sattvat. Because all the kamas are in Brahman, therefore reaching Brahman also is as good as reaching all the kamas. Tat praptya, tat prapti sambhavati. Therefore, Brahma praptya, by attainment of Brahman, attainment of kama is already there. Because, so when you go to a house, you have everything in there. So by going to a house, it gets TV and it gets refrigerator, because it's all there. And so, if you suppose rented a house or you bought a house, furnished, all furniture is there. So you go to a house, but you get the furniture also, because the furniture is already there in the house. So you go to Brahman, but you get all the kamas, because kamas are already in Brahman. Therefore, tat praptya tat prapti sambhavadeti. Tatra hetu paratvena vyakyam vyachaste. So the following vakya is a hetu for saying how one attains all the kamas by attainment of Brahman. So either we can look at it either way. That it is the conclusion of how there is anuta abhidhanam, or conclusion as to how all the kamas are in Brahman. So Vashyakara says atra iti, in the sixth line, atra asmin hardakashehi yasmat asya ete yathoktaha satyaha kamaha vartante anuta pidhanaha. So he is yasmas hetu, because so tatra hetu paratvena vakyam vyachaste. How come one attains all the kamas by knowledge of Brahman? Hetu paratvena, because yasmat atrahi ete satyaha kamaha vartante. Because atra in Brahman itself, asmin hardakashe. In here means in the hrudayakasha of Brahman. Yes, ete, yatho means all, yathoktaha. What is it then? The putra and bhratra, etc., all of the whatever else they want, ratnadi, vastrapanadi, etc., all of this. Satyaha kamaha vartante, they all obtain there. Satyaha kama is amazing. So, understand, kamaha satyaha, all these objects are real. Happiness is real, but anuta apidhanaha, but they are veiled by falsehood. So, real means that it should be available to you, but they are veiled by falsehood, therefore not available. So either you can say that this is a hetu for the unavailability of the kama, or the hetu of saying all the kamas are in Brahman, either way. Because kamas are in Brahman and still they are not vain, because there is a apidhanam, the veil of falsehood. So both ways. So says the Tika in line 38, Hardakashabde Brahmani. There is asmin Hardakashe Brahmani. Harda means in Brahman. Anuda pidanaha iti anantaram ata andu parityagena kamanam atma pratyakshata anapadanam anyayam vidisheshaha. So there in the seventh line, anuta pidanaha, that's why the sentence got completed. The Tikakara says you should add something there to complete the sense. Anuta pidanati anantar, after that you add this. Ataha therefore, then only you can understand what follows. So connection between this sentence and next sentence you can understand, provided you add this in between. What do you add? Ataha anuta parityagena kamanam atma pratyakshara anapadanam. So then all that is deprive you is anutam, falsehood. All you need to do is to give up that falsehood. So here when you realize that this is not to be attained as a result of some exploration, that you go to Himalayas, etc., and get those things. Right with you? So all that you need to do is give this falsehood, that's all. What's the falsehood? I'm a jiva. Ahankara, mamakara, raga, dvesha, trushna, all of this falsehood. So it is not that you acquire something really, you have to just give up something. Tyagenike amrutattvamanasuhu. Amrutattvam is already there. You just tyaga, the giving up of all this falsehood. That should be easy. Our Swamiji said the easiest thing should be self-knowledge, because it's your own self. And still, apratyakshata anapadam, and still the person doesn't do that. Apratyakshata anapadam. He does not make them, so he does not get rid of this apratyakshata. They are pratyaksha, they are in his own self. It is falsehood that is creating the distance. So what is immediate is as though made remote, you know. What in the tenth man is immediate, but that ignorance makes it remote as though he is somewhere else. Similarly also all the kamas are immediate within myself, but this anuttam falsehood, which is apidhanam, that veil, only creates a distance, false distance, and creates a notion that they are away from me. So it is not that I have to physically bring them to me. I just have to become free from the notion that they are away from me. And that notion has arisen because of ignorance of myself. Therefore, I have to gain the knowledge of myself. And therefore, constantly deliberate upon yourself. Anusandhan, I'm constant meditation on myself. I happen to be Brahman. That Hardakasa is myself. As you call it, Dharakasa, Hardakasa is myself. You don't have to become Hardakasa. All you need to do is assert that I'm Hardakasa, Hardakasa, Hardakasa. Not a jiva, Hardakasa. Dharakasa. Keep doing it until it becomes a reality, because it's a reality. If the Dharakasa was not your nature, then it would be a superimposition, or it would be, what shall I say, another notion, another delusion. But this meditation is meditation upon what is already there but not known to you, that's all. So meditation is simply constantly repeating this fact. Dharakasoham, dharakasoham, dharakasoham. At the exclusion of all thoughts, then slowly dharakasa becomes favorable to you. And slowly you realize it is your own self. He's not doing it. So that is really regretful. So regret is that he's not doing what he should be doing. That's all he should be doing, in fact. After all, this fellow is constantly striving to get happiness in a wrong, all the efforts are all in the wrong direction. It's not that he doesn't want happiness, that all he wants is happiness. For that he is making efforts in wrong direction. And then his efforts are not yielding the kind of result that he wants. So the effort that he should be making is this effort that we already told, that he is not making. So he is not doing what he should have been doing, and keeps on doing what he should not be doing. So that is where the regret is. If that fellow did not do anything, then it's also okay. But he is constantly doing something wrong and thus inviting a lot of struggle for himself. In the life of this person, all the stress and conflict is there because he is striving something, striving to achieve something which is not achievable. It is like trying to extract oil out of sand, which will never happen. Similarly, extracting happiness from the objects where it is not, that is not going to happen. And therefore, poor fellow is making all the efforts. So, samane pi ayasa. The ayasa or exertion would be the same. And still, he does not get the benefit of an exertion. That is a regret. When you see your child or somebody you love, doing things and not listening to you, or otherwise doing something which is wrong. He's hurting himself. So then, in spite of your telling, he doesn't do it. The parent, my father says, or mother says, look, this is what you should do, he doesn't do. That's where the regret comes. How sad it is that I know that he can do. I'm telling him. And still, for whatever reason, he does not do that. So Shruti says, I'm telling him that you are the Dharakasha. And what is the dimension of Dharakasha? Yavanva, as vast as this external akasha. So vast is this in dimension. And then, in this akasha, Dharakasha, the whole universe is nihitam, is located. Including heaven and earth, that's what it is, that's your dimension. You're not what you take yourself to be, your dimension is this. But you have to realize the dimension. So give up your identification with small dimension and strive to identify with the true dimension. So this meditation is of the nature of a constant effort to identify with my true dimension. If you do it, suppose you don't want to do that, whatever else you do is a waste of effort. Other than that, if there was another way of getting that happiness, it's all right, but there's no other way. Therefore, whatever else he does, it's going to be a waste of effort. It's only going to be an exertion, nothing else. It is like offering oblations in ashes, not in fire. So therefore, the mother feels bad. Mother or parent feels really bad. It's so sad, sorrowful. So that is where the regret is on the part of Shruti. Let me told you this. And you, this is what you should be doing. Still not doing it. Therefore, kamaram apratyashra anapadanam. And so, atma pratyashra anapadanam. That you are not making it pratyaksha, not making immediate, but the right effort. Anyayam, that is really bad or unreasonable, it is sad. Only when you add this sentence, then alone the next sentence will be properly connected. Or going to Anandagiri, because Nigamayati, how does this Shruti actually say, Anutapidhanatvam, how falsehood becomes an apidhanam? Yasmat avidvadbhi alabhyaha, vidvadbhischa labhyaha, satyaha kamaha. Since satyaha kamaha, those true resolves or desires, avidvadbhi alabhyaha, they are unattainable by those who have not realized their own self, vidvadbhischa labhyaha, and they are attained by those who realize the self. Sarvadhare Virade, Sarvadhare Jagan Mulakarane, Brahmani, Swatma Bhute Vartante. So, because Atrahi Asyete Asatyaha Kamaha Antapidanaha Vartante. Here itself we are. So, Atrahi means what? Brahmani, Swatma Bhute Vartante, they all there. Tasmate bhavanti. So the satyaha kama is right here. And still ignorant person doesn't get them. Means what? There is a veil. And therefore this kamaha, the qualification or adjective is what? Anuta apidanaha kama. So anutam apidanam yeshante anuta apidanam. So those anuta apidanam is what? Those who are anutam as apidanam. Those who are falsehood as a very veil. So on one hand, you call them satyaha kama, you see. Satyaha kama is the true desires and they should be available to you. If the desires of the objects or happiness, satyam as you describe them, then you should be experiencing them and you are not. Why? Because anuta pidanaha, there is a veil of falsehood. So even though they are satyaha and still an ignorant person does not experience them, so that there is something that separates the satyaha kama from him, There is an apidanam, a separation, and there is a falsehood. So this proves that the kamas are anudapidanah, the kamas are those which are separated by this falsehood, by the veil of falsehood. Or you can say that how what is already there can be attained by the realization of your own self. Both ways. Again, anvirje satyam avidyayam anupalambhat vidyaya tat prashamanecha upalambhat ityartah. Satyam avidyayam. Satyam means what? Satyam avidyayam is not real avidya. Satyam avidyayam sati saptami. When ignorance is there. Anupalambhat. So this is anvaya vyatirika. Satyam avidyayam anupalambhat. When ignorance is there, then you do not attain those desires. Vidya tat prashamane. And when that ignorance is dispelled by knowledge, upalambhat, then there is attainment. So as long as ignorance is there, an attainment. When ignorance is dispelled by knowledge, there is attainment. Therefore, this satya, kama, these two desires also are veiled by the veil of falsehood. See again, Anandagiri, yaduktam brahmani swatmani kama santopino pulabhyante iti anyayamiti. Yaduktam, what is said? Brahmani swatmani kama santopi. Brahman, which is one's own self, in which all the kamas or desires are there, in spite of their being there, no pulabhyante, one does not attain. It is anyayam. So that is unreasonable. It's not reasonable, it's unreasonable. So nyayam, in keeping with nyaya, in keeping with reason. Nyayam means in keeping with reason. Anyayam, not in keeping with reason. Doesn't sound fair. Looks unfair. Then the desires are within you, you don't get them. How come this unfair thing happens? Unfairness. So, idi tatra drushtantam prasna purukam uttapya vyachaste. So, Upanishad itself gives a drushtanta of how something is there and still deprived of it, gives a beautiful example, illustration. So, therefore, that nigamanam is there. It has been proven now that there are anutta satya kama anutta pidana. That there is, these desires are veiled by the falsehood. For that an example is given, illustration. And so, idi tatra dushtantam prasnapuru uttapya. So this was stated by Bhashyakara. Brahmani kama santopi no palabhyante. Idanyayam. This exact sentence is not stated, in fact, by Bhashyakara so far. So, kastamidam khalu vartate idi bhashya. Point is, Bhashyakara said, kastamidam khalu vartante in the previous passage. It is really sorrowful or regretful. So, meaning, it is, what is regretful? The regret can be there only when something is possible and it is not there. Then only there can be regret. Meaning that fellow, if you strive, then you will pass the exam. You will go to engineering school or medical school, do that. And still there is regret because even though it is possible, it is not happening. It is not doing it. The regret is only that way. So therefore, either you call it a regret because it is unreasonable. It's not in keeping with reason. So either, so when Bhashyakara is regretful, in a way it was implied that it's anyayam or unreasonable. It is adrushtandam prasnapurga uttapya. To show Bhashya, the Shruti gives this illustration which Bhashyakara explains preceded by question kathaniti. उदा टीकाकरस अत्र उत्तरवाक्यम दृष्टांत प्रदर्शनार्थत्वेन अवतारयति. ओके सो सेम थिंग फॉलोइंग सेंटेंसेस ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ दृष्टांत इलस्ट्रेशन. सो हेतु इज गिवन नाउ दृष्टांत इज बीइंग गिवन. व्हाट इज हेतु अत्र यस्य एते सत्याः कामाः अन्तःपिधानाः हेतु. व्हाट इज दृष्टांत हिरण्यनिधि. सो कथम इत्यादि ना सुभाष्यकार सेस कथमिव तत अन्यायम् इति उच्यते. दैट अनरीजनेबल थिंग इज इन व्हाट मैनर कथमिव इन व्हाट मैनर. सो हाउ डू एक्सप्लेन दैट कथमिव मीन्स व्हाट दैट लाइक व्हाट. So like what? This unreasonable thing is like what? Means an illustration. So kathamiva is asking for an illustration. Where else do you see this? This anyaya, unreasonable thing. That one is deprived of what is already one's own. Where else do you see that? So you want to sometimes, so the conviction comes when there is an illustration. So hetu is given. These are already here and you are not getting it. But then is there an illustration that something is here and you are not getting it? The hetu becomes very clear by the drishtanta, then the whole principle becomes very clear to you. Therefore, kathamiva, where is the example to say that such unreasonable thing is there? What is unreasonable? That it is already there and you are still not getting it. That unreasonable thing, where do you see it? If that's a question, Uchyate, then this Shruti herself replies that. Tata, tatra, yatha, hiranyanidhim, hiranyam eva, punargrahanaya, nidhatrabihi, निधीयते इति निधि तम हिरण्यनिधिम निहितम भूमेः अधस्तात् निक्षिप्तम अक्षेत्रज्ञाः निधिशास्त्रैः निधिक्षेत्रम् अजानन्तः ते निधेः उपरि उपरि संचरन्तोपि निधिं न विन्देयुः शक्यवेदनम् अपि. सो कथमिव सो वेरी द सिमिलारिटी ऑफ दिस दट मीन्स तत्र विथ रेफरेंस टू दिस इलस्ट्रेशन यथा जस्ट एज हिरण्यनिधिं द ट्रेजर ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ द गोल्डन ट्रेजर. So Vashyakara explains the word Nidhi. So what is buried underneath is gold. It is called treasure or Nidhi. What is Nidhi? Hiranyameva Nidhi. Not that it is a treasure of gold. Gold itself is a treasure. So punagrahanaya nidhatravi nidhiyate iti Nidhi. So that which is placed is called Nidhi. For what? Punagrahanaya, so that you can get it back. So therefore, you have saved it there. So people used to save money, etc., by burying them in the ground. There were no banks those days. And there was always a question about the thieves, etc. Therefore, you bury it underground, such that nobody will suspect it, you know. So some great grandfather has buried it, and then ultimately he never revealed it to anybody. Maybe he died, without him, but then people knew. The old people knew that he has buried it someplace. It's there. They also died. So what happens when they die? Then now nobody knows that this Hiranya is there. So this great grandfather had actually buried it or placed it for retrieving it again. So you place it there not forever. Otherwise not Nidhi. It can be Nidhi, but here, what is Nidhi? Punargrahanaya nidhiyate. It is placed it in there, hidden in there for retrieving again in future. So that is Hiranyaniti, the goal which is buried in there for retrieving in future. That way it is retrievable. The idea is that it is retrievable. It was placed there for not retrieving, then it may have been placed in a different way. That nobody will ever get it. I don't know, somebody may do that. But here, this elder one in the family, he had placed it for retrieving in future. Maybe my children will get it. My great-grandchildren will get them. So there is called Hiranyanidhi, which is to be retrieved, which is retrievable. Nihitam where? Bhume adhastat. It is placed there, buried there, underneath, in the bhumi, in the soil. So adhastat nikshiptam akshetrajnya. But this present generation doesn't know the present any such thing there. What akshetrajnya? Kshetra means a field. They do not know the field. They do not know the farm. So nidhi shastrai nidhi kshetram ajananta. There is shastra also, by which you can know what treasures are buried. So there are people whose only business is to go to mountains and look for these treasures. Because in mountains also things may be buried, or in mountains there are sometimes the mines. So sometimes there are these treasures there in the mountains. Maybe because earth is Vasundhara, you know. So earth has all kinds of jewels within herself. So people are looking for that. Anyway, so there is a science by which you can locate this kind of hidden treasures. And these fellows are unaware of that. Akshetrajnyaha. So Nidhishastrai, either you know it through the scriptures, so which teach you how to locate those treasures. Nidhishastrai, Nidhikshetram Ajanantaha. Neither they knew it from some elder person who knew it was there, or they did not know it, they would have known it from study of this kind of books, and then they would have known. They don't know. Those unfortunate fellows, nide upari upari sancharantobi, it is in that kshetra, it is in their own farm, in their own field, which they are tilling every day. So upari upari, every day, upari upari sancharantobi, every day they are walking, you know, on that treasure. Nidhim na vindeyuhu, they do not know or they do not gain. So within the sense of labha also, or jnana, so that they do not know or they do not get it. Shakya vedanapi, even though it is retrievable, and still they do not retrieve it because they do not know. So ignorance and knowledge creates all the difference. Had they known, so kshetrajnya, they said, akshetrajnya. Because they are ignorant of the kshetra or this treasure, therefore they are deprived of benefit of what is already theirs. If you knew, then it becomes yours. So therefore, what is the kshetra? Where is that nidhi? It's anudapidhanam. That nidhi or the treasure is something that is separated by a falsehood. What is falsehood? Ignorance. Ignorance, ajnanam is the anutam. So ignorance of the fact that this treasure is there. And because of that, the notion that there is nothing there. And because of that, there is no effort to acquire it, retrieve it. And because of that, always looking for gold elsewhere, you know. So not where it is. They say this fellow wants money, of course. And the fellow is striving to get money from various things where it is not there, and then he doesn't try where it is. So very apt example of unattainment of what is attained or attainable because of ignorance. So how what is already there is separated by the veil of falsehood. So tatra Swayatasya aprapto drishtanto nirdishyate iti shesha. So tat means tatra. Then Bhashyakara says, Anagiri, Svayattasya aprapto drishtando nirnishade tatra. Here by the Shruti, drishtando nirnishade, an illustration is provided. For what? Aprapto, unattainment of Svayattasya. So what is one's own? Attainment of what is one's own? For that, the example is given by the Shruti. Okay, we'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamivavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om.